So what I'm going to do today is I want to show you how to use the roar, how to get the full benefit out of using a roar, because I see a lot of people actually using it wrong. So first thing I'm going to do, in the foot straps, tighten it up, make sure you're in a nice comfortable position. So when you're coming forward to pick up the handle, I personally prefer putting my knees out to the side, simply because when my knees are together, it kind of stops me from getting that full distance and coming forward. So knees out to the side. When you're coming forward, allow your arms to be full extension, reach up as far as you can. You're going to allow your chest to slightly come forward. From there, you're going to push back through your legs. So with this, all the power, most of the power is going to come through your legs. So you want to be trying to get triple extension on this. So what I mean by that is, from here, you're going to pull, push through the legs, get full extension, and then start bringing the handle up towards your chest, while slightly leaning back as well. So again, as you're coming forward, knees slightly out to the side, get the foot pushing through the legs, pulling up towards your chest. So what I normally tend to see with people is what happens is they'll be pulling and they'll be just going like this. So what they're missing out on is, first of all, they're missing the full extension through your legs of getting that full power up, because that's where most of the power is going to come from. Secondly, they're missing the extension of leaning back and getting the full length of the cable coming right up. So you're missing out on massive amounts of power there. Also as well, what I find with people is when they're pulling towards them, they'll get to a certain distance and they'll start to go backwards. So they'll be pulling and they'll start to move back in. And what happens there is, same thing again, you're going against the force of pulling forward. So you're trying to get that forward extension, but you're not allowing yourself because you're already starting to move back inwards. So make sure you're pulling hard, full extension, relax, breathe back in. You're getting that full extension each and every time. You'll find that you'll develop so much more power, you'll be using your legs a lot more, you'll be a lot more efficient on the rower. And it's not about trying to go up and down as quick as you can. It's all about this power, fast strides out, breathe on the way back in. Fast strides out, breathe on the way back in. As part of your recovery is going to be coming in, using your power coming back. So try those little techniques with it, with your strides per minute. I normally try and tend to keep it between about 26 to maybe 32 max. Some people, when they do it, they're like 50 strides per minute. Again, they're going too quick. Slow it down, focus more on the power, the push through the legs and the power through the arms in that upright row position, bring it right up towards the chest. So, hope that was tips were helpful, and let me know how you got on the road.